Welcome back. Now, Chief Minister Jayalalitha today told the Assembly that biometric smart family cards will be issued to the people of the state from 2012-2013. Now, she told the House that duplication of members and bogus cards will be eliminated because of this initiative. Now, the validity of the existing family cards will expire on the 31st of December 2011. Now, she also said that the bills can be drawn only if the cards are physically brought to the fair price shop. Now, she said that this will eliminate bogus billing. The replacing of existing cards with smart family cards will be based on the data collected by the National Population Registry for the unique identification number, according to the Chief Minister. And in more developments from the Assembly, Tamil Nadu State Electricity Minister Natham Vishwanathan today told the Assembly that overhead electric cables in Chennai, Trichy, Coimbatore, Palani, Madurai and Tindivanam will be converted into underground cables at a cost of 406 crore rupees. He also added that places with a population of over 30,000 will be given priority. And well, if you thought that you can buy gold either as an investment or as a jewelry item, it appears that every passing day will cost you more. A combination of global triggers and increased demand within India on account of wedding and festive season price of gold, in fact, has hit an all-time high of 28,150 rupees for 10 grams. Meanwhile, 24-carat gold in China's jewelry stores will cost you 27,980 rupees for every 10 grams. With worries of a double-dip recession in the US, economic worries in the Eurozone, and India itself are looking at muted growth, there has been an increased push by global investors to buy gold. Gold is regarded widely as one of the safest avenues of investment. Now, though analysts advise a bit of caution, there is consensus on the upward trajectory of the price of these items. Well, gold is certainly pinching the pocket. Will food prices pinch your pocket again? That's one question that many households will find themselves asking if the ongoing strike by truckers were to continue. And as the truckers of South India go meanwhile on a region-wide strike, the movement of various food articles is expected to get hampered, resulting in hike in prices. Take a look.
The price of vegetables is expected to soar after truckers decided to go on a strike. Currently, the price of key vegetables stands at tomatoes at 11 rupees, potato 25 rupees, onions 22 rupees, small onions at 35 rupees, brinjal 19 rupees, cabbage 15 rupees, beans 26 rupees, carrots 29 rupees, and lady's finger at 19 rupees.
Vengayam, urlai, thakkali, carrot beans, number 8 na adhigamagum, rate normal rate idha adhigamagum, vera mathapilla ellame normal ah da irukum.
We saw the news that the prices are increasing, so that we are here to buy some vegetables.
Demand வந்து நார்மலா தான் இருக்கு. நாளைக்கு எப்படி இருக்கும் தெரியாதனால நாங்க இப்ப நிறைய எல்லாம் வாங்கி சேவ் பண்ணி டம்ப் பண்ணி வச்சிருக்கோம்.
இதுல விலைய பார்க்க முடியாது. ஏனா காய்கறி முக்கியம், எசன்ஷியல். 1 கிலோ வாங்குறது, 1 கிலோ வாங்குறது, ஒரு நாளைக்கு வாங்குறது, இப்ப 4 நாளைக்கு 5 நாளைக்கு சேர்த்து வாங்குறோம்.
On to other developments now. The residents of Triplicane woke up to a shocking news at the crack of dawn. 41-year-old Murthy, a contractor in Chennai Harbour, was found murdered with his throat slit in a mansion in their locality. Now, the police moved the body to Roy Bett Government Hospital for an autopsy and initiated a probe. Police say that they suspect previous enmity to be the cause of the crime. A special police team has gone outside Chennai in search of the accused persons. And while the intake of students in medical colleges, also considered hotbeds of ragging, have begun. Now, the facilities are keen, in fact, on creating awareness among the students about the ill effects of ragging, as the Tamil Nadu Prohibition of Ragging Act holds them culpable if the action was not initiated on ragging complaints. Now, addressing an anti-ragging seminar hosted by the Madras Medical College to raise awareness of the consequences of indulging in ragging, Dr. C. Sailendra Babu, Inspector General of Police North Zone, explained to students that indulging in ragging directly or indirectly, abetment, participation or propagation was also an offence under the Act and involved imprisonment up to 2 years and a fine.
Today, ragging is an offense. Doctor knows, your dean knows, when you're on the college, it is be very severe ragging. The seniors will come, they beat you, they make you naked, they make you run, they may ask you to swim on the floor, they may ask you to dance naked. Serious problems were there earlier point of time. Now the ragging has come down very drastically. Still, we get complaints of ragging once in a while from the colleges. But as a senior student, particularly the second year student and third year student, you must understand, because of the Supreme Court guidelines, because of Dr. Raghavan's recommendation, ragging is made a criminal offense. If the principal is not taking any action, it will be presumed that he is also abetting the offense of ragging. You understand? There's a principal, he's keeping quiet. After all, Madras Medical College, good name, should not be spoiled. He's also son of my own colleague or grandson of my relative. Let us excuse him, let him go. But if it happens, if the matter is brought to the notice of the concerned authority, now the principal, the dean, will be presumed to have abetted, supported, helped the offense of ragging, and he is also punishable. He can also be punished for the same 2 years imprisonment as the student. He is smiling. This is the only best way to punish my principal. Both of us will be in the same jail, this side and that side. If that is the intention, you do it. Otherwise, for heaven's sake, please don't do.
Well, up on the other side, how did the movies that released today hit? Is it a hit or a miss? Keep watching and find out for yourself on the other side.